Main story really in the GTA was that it stayed red when many people didn't expect it to. Areas that were thought to be in jeopardy of going conservative, especially in the 905 region, did not flip to blue. Now take a look here. This is what 2015 looked like when the Liberals had a majority government. It was a wave of red in Toronto and really across the GTA. The NDP were expected to perform strongly, taking some of the votes away from the Liberals this time around, possibly making room for the Conservatives to sweep in and take over some of the ridings. But take a look at 2019. That really did not happen. All of Toronto going back to the Liberal incumbents, with only a couple of ridings in the Greater Toronto Area up north flipping to Conservative. The GTA playing a big role in the Liberals securing the minority government.
Bill Morneau retaining his seat in Toronto Centre and Chrystia Freeland securing another term as MP, both at the heart of Toronto, a city that saw red.
The big story in the GTA is really the vote efficiency of the Liberal Party.
The Liberals' strategy that appeared to have worked to equate the federal Conservatives to their provincial counterpart.
To really try to bring Premier Doug Ford into this campaign and to really make him a point of controversy. It was a thought on the minds of people when they went in and considered what a Conservative vote might bring.
There was one notable Ford in the federal election, though. Former Toronto Mayor Rob Ford's widow, Renata Ford, ran for the People's Party of Canada in Etobicoke North, but came up well short of beating longtime Liberal incumbent Kirsty Duncan.
Well, it was exciting. It was very nice. Rob didn't win the first time, and, you know, we might be back to the polls in 2 years. So we'll be back, and we'll try again and see.
Jane Philpott lost her seat in the riding of Markham-Stouffville. The former health minister was kicked out of the Liberal caucus amid the SNC-Lavalin affair. She ran as an independent this time around and lost to the new Liberal candidate.
There is an appetite, a thirst, to change our political culture in a positive way.
And probably one of the most exciting races to watch was in Milton, where Liberal newcomer and Olympic medalist Adam Van Cooverden upset Conservative incumbent Lisa Raitt.
I ran a great campaign, and obviously the riding has changed, and that's okay. The people of Milton have spoken. The voter is never incorrect. They always get it right.
And so, speaking of those voters, when it comes to voter turnout, take a look at this number. 67% of eligible voters cast a ballot. That's higher than 2008 and 2011 numbers, far, but not as high as 2015, that saw a nearly 69% voter turnout.
All right, yeah, that was a very different election. Thanks so much for that.